Hello YouTube, my name's Nero and today we have some more Call of Duty Black Ops 3 news. Two more Snapchats have actually released. I was waiting, hoping that a lot more of these end up coming out, but so far two more of them have actually released. And if you actually put these in the timeline of the story itself, it actually makes a whole lot of sense. And a lot of early predictions that a lot of people had seem to be actually pretty accurate based upon these two Snapchats. So let's play the first one for you guys here.
The human mind holds many mysteries.
The human mind holds many mysteries. Now, there's one more Snapchat. Let's listen to that real quick.
I am deeply optimistic about this project's potential. Of course, the human consciousness is fundamentally unpredictable.
I am deeply optimistic about this project's potential. Of course, the human consciousness is fundamentally unpredictable. Now, let's go back to the first Snapchat we watched and look at what we got here. Here's a screen cap here. We're seeing a brain, right? We're seeing a brain and it's talking about the human mind and how it can hold many mysteries. Then we see this picture here and we see a doctor. This is right at the very end of the Snapchat, right before it kind of goes to fuzziness. You see this person, it's a doctor obviously operating on somebody. Now, we'll go to the second Snapchat that was released and we look at this picture. We, of course, see a doctor with the mask on, somebody that's doing an operation, right? And, of course, you see here, it's basically that of an operation. Now, what I want to go ahead and do for you guys in this video is try to play for you every single Snapchat that has actually been released by Call of Duty so far. And I think you guys are going to see kind of a pattern here.
Listen only to the sound of my voice. Let your thoughts drift. Let the bad memories fade. Let peace be upon you. Imagine somewhere calm. Imagine somewhere safe. Imagine yourself in a frozen forest. Our greatest barrier is our own fear. Our own doubts. The human mind holds many mysteries. I am deeply optimistic about this project's potential. Of course, the human consciousness is fundamentally unpredictable.
All right, let's talk about this here. So the very last Snapchat that's been released so far, you hear this doctor talking, and one's going to assume it's Dr. Salim, right? S-A-L-I-M. This is the doctor that was teased to us and a bunch of different things that we've gotten from Call of Duty so far. A lot of Snapchats that they actually sent out, you can actually change around the coloring of the Snapchat itself. And of course, you can actually see it's a Dr. Salim in the air. The Call of Duty Snapchat account itself actually, of course, changed their name to Dr. Salim as well. One's going to assume that he is the doctor. And during that, you hear him talking about this project. I think that's a very key word, is this project. And you hear in the background, you hear the person that I think that they were operating on. You kind of hear them as if they're still alive. You hear them heavily breathing, hear going, you know, that kind of idea. You can definitely hear that. So if I had to try and break down, I suppose, every single one of these Snapchats in a row, basically at the very beginning, he is talking to the person that they're operating on, right? He's talking to them, telling them to calm down, relax, listen to the sound of his voice, picture himself somewhere calm, someplace safe in a white forest. Then, of course, the operation starts happening. Then he's talking to one of his colleagues. I believe that's where we kind of find ourselves here. If I had to make a prediction, if I had to try and break this down and kind of say, what is this? Like, give you guys an idea of what I believe this could be. I believe this is actually what a lot of people thought this was towards the very beginning of these teasers. I feel as though what we're going to see in Call of Duty Black Ops 3 is a world where super soldiers are being created for whatever reason. We're not entirely sure what that is. If we go back to the last video I made talking about Black Ops 3 news, we actually learned a lot about Black Ops 3 from the official Call of Duty website itself by looking at the source code of the website, and in there we got a little bit of a description. Now let's go back and read that for you guys. Call of Duty Black Ops 3 deploys players into a dark, twisted future where a new breed of Black Ops soldier emerges, and the lines are blurred between our own humanity and the technologies we created to stay ahead in a world where cutting-edge military robotics define warfare. Ladies and gentlemen, I believe what is happening in these Snapchats, what we're we're learning from these is we're actually seeing that new breed of Black Ops soldier actually being created. It's being created by these doctors, by these surgeons, with this Dr. Salem guy that we've been hearing so much about. I feel as though he is connected with it, and they are putting together these new Black Ops soldiers. Now, why are they putting them together? We don't know. We do know that this is apparently going to be a dark and twisted future. Is this Dr. Salem on our side? Are these Black Ops soldiers the good guys? Are they the people we're going to be playing as, or are they the bad guys? Is this like an evil group of people that are putting together this quote-unquote new breed of Black Ops soldier, these super soldiers, if you will? Because we go back and we look at this picture here, which is apparently the leaked cover art, right, of Black Ops 3. We see that guy. We see how much crazy technology things he's got on him. We can't. Some people are saying those are flashbangs up there on his shoulders. I think they might be shotgun shells, to be perfectly honest, but who knows, right? This guy has so much technology on him, so much so that people are speculating that that could be an exosuit, which a lot of people don't want that to be exosuits in the game. A lot of people are just so against the idea of exosuits. But regardless of that, he has a bunch of technology, bunch of robotic stuff on him, right? But you can see here, especially if I change around how the colorings worked on this picture, you can see there's actually a human face. That is an actual person. It's not a robot. There actually is flesh there. So basically what I feel is happening here is they are making these half man, half robot super soldier things, which is something that a lot of people thought was going to be the case from the very beginning, because when we initially thought Black Ops 3 was going to be a World War II game, a lot of people were looking up the idea of different World War II projects, which there were a lot. Some of them were done, of course, by the Nazis. Some were done by the Russians. A lot of different factions, I suppose, in World War II were trying to make quote-unquote super soldiers, right? And that's something a lot of people thought that it could be the setting of Black Ops 3, which apparently is right. If all the things are coming in line here, this just makes perfect sense to me. All these snapshots that have been released, I played them in order for you guys. You look at the official description that you can find in the source code of the Call of Duty website talking about this new breed of Black Ops soldier is going to emerge, and it's going to blur the lines between our own humanity and the technology that we create to stay ahead in a world where cutting-edge military robotics define warfare. I think it's pretty safe to say that what we're seeing and what we've been seeing throughout all of these snapshots is this soldier is going to be one of these soldiers, right, from the series. It could be Alex Mason himself, because of course they showed Vietnam-based things, and it could just be him. They're working on him. He's now going to be this super crazy half-robot, half-man. You look at the official Call of Duty trailer itself for Black Ops 3 that came out, you get that quote from Woods: they're always going to need men like us, right? That's just something that stuck with me so well from that trailer, because during Black Ops 2, what they do with Black Ops 2, right? They made it so the game was kind of futuristic, right? They made it so it's kind of futuristic, and Woods, throughout all the marketing campaigns and stuff, he's like, so what are they going to do when someone else gets the key, right? They made it so basically the whole world's ran by robotics, right? The whole world's ran by these drones and stuff. So what are they going to do when the bad guy controls that? That was the whole point of what Woods was saying in those trailers and during the campaign of Black Ops 2. He's like, what are they going to do? They're always going to need men like us. They're always going to need the actual soldier, the badass, to go in there, right? And I feel as though, since they said that in the trailer, I feel as though that's what we're going to be seeing. These soldiers, how we're going to need them is they're going to be turning those soldiers into these crazy half-cyborg, crazy Black Ops soldiers. That's what I feel as though is happening here. That's what I feel as though is going to be happening in Black Ops 3. Of course, ladies and gentlemen, April 26th, 2015, that is when we will be getting our world reveal, and we will be learning a lot more, of course, about Call of Duty Black Ops 3 at the time of this video going up, at the time of me recording this. It's all speculation, but I'm just saying all the pieces are coming together for me anyway, guys. I feel so this is really what we're going to be having in Black Ops 3. It just makes far too much sense for this not to be the case. So let me know in the comment section below what you guys think. I'm pleasantly surprised to see that they're still continuing their Snapchat advertising campaign that they're doing right now, because something I like, man, I like the fact that people are able to break down this kind of stuff, that people are like me are making videos out of it. We're like, hey, look at this here. This is possibly means this, that, and the other. And it's making the community work together in a way that I've never seen in any other marketing campaign before. Everybody's working together to kind of try and figure all this stuff out, rather than people just watching a trailer. We're breaking down videos, and they're coming via Snapchats, which of course disappear. It's really cool, man. It's a really cool campaign by Treyarch. They're just so ridiculously awesome over there. It's definitely my favorite studio for Call of Duty, man. Definitely my favorite studio. Well, let me know in the comment section below, do you agree with my theory here? Do you think that is a plausible theory, I should say, for Black Ops 3? Do you think that's the case? If you have a differing opinion, of course, let me know in the comment section below. I hope you guys all enjoyed this video, and if you did, please be sure to leave a rating where you guys feel it deserves. Hope you guys all have a wonderful day.